time, I'd like to welcome one of our congressional candidates who is endorsed in Congressional District 5. Please give me a big round of applause for Chris Fields.
Fifth CD, where are you? Fifth CD! Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Ladies and gentlemen, Minneapolis in the 5th Congressional District is the home to wonderful people and wonderful Fortune 500 companies. We are also the home of the largest achievement gap in education between black and white students in the entire country. We are also home to the largest unemployment gap between blacks and whites in the entire country. And here's why I need you to care. Because failed policies, bad leadership, are making our district, and in fact our state, a national embarrassment. I am the endorsed Republican challenger to Keith Maurice Ellison, and I will take the 5th back. My name is Chris Fields. I'm a 21-year combat veteran of the United States Marine Corps. Hoorah! Thank you. Thank you. Look, I'll be the first to tell folks that I was not born and raised in Minnesota. I was born and raised in the South Bronx, born to a 15-year-old welfare mother who had 3 kids before she was 20. And for that reason, I am very unapologetic about being pro-life. I know firsthand what failed policies do to the most vulnerable amongst us. I have personally felt the stinging shame of walking in and out of welfare offices and using food stamps. Those experiences left me with a deep desire to work, earn, and achieve. And I have achieved. But because I've achieved, that's why I'm standing before you. But that's not my purpose. My purpose is so that I can help everyone achieve. They tell me that winning back the 5th is going to be tough. But I stand here fully prepared because I know what it takes to win tough battles. Growing up dirt poor in New York City, that's tough. Fighting in Iraq, that's tough. We can win in the 5th, and in order to win, I need every single delegate and alternate and Republican and independent and conservative Democrat in this state to get involved so we can take it back. Yeah. I'll give you a couple ways you can get involved. Friend us, like our Facebook page, that's not tough. Follow us on Twitter. That's not tough. Send a letter to the editor. That's not tough. Buy a t-shirt. We take credit cards. It's really not that tough. Send in 10 bucks. Tell your friends about this race. This one will be one for the ages. Because while Keith is running around talking with all of his special interest buddies about how the earth has a fever and we can't drill for oil because of that, while he's doing all of those things, I'm going to be focused on the 5th Congressional District in Minneapolis, and I'm going to build together a coalition that is ready to bring in a new era of leadership. And he will try those old stale techniques of trying to divide people and tell them that 2012 is about choosing between left and right. I will unite the people and remind them this is about choosing what's right. And let me tell you, what's right is a full and complete audit of the Fed. What's right is ending the war in Afghanistan. What's right is standing up for America. What's right is standing up for single moms and single dads. What's right is standing up for students and standing up for the middle class and standing up for our seniors and our veterans. What's right is when the entire GOP decides to fight in the Minneapolis in the 5th Congressional District so that we can give ourselves a chance to win statewide races. That's what's right. And what's right is fighting in Minneapolis so we can keep Keith Ellison's million-dollar fundraising machine out of your district. And finally, when the doubters and naysayers come, they'll look at me and I say, hey, Chris Fields, who do you think you are, Alan West? My answer will be this, no, because frankly, I'm better looking. And when they come up to me and they say, do you really think that you can win in the fifth? Do you really think that you can beat Keith Ellison? You're not even from here. Well, I will stare at him with the steely-eyed look of a Marine and give him two words. You betcha. Thank you and God bless. God bless you. God bless the United States of America.